speak to you this morning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today is the first Sunday after Christmas. The watching and waiting is over. We've celebrated the birth of Christ. The gifts have been unwrapped. Kids have played with their toys or tried on their new outfits. And soon we'll be ringing in a new year. But it begs the question, now what? What happens next? As a community of God's children, God's sons and daughters, sisters and brothers in Christ, what do we do now in this liminal space between Christmas and a brand new year that inches towards the season of Epiphany? Not many of us may use this time to make goals or New Year's resolutions, or maybe create vision boards. Or we choose to reflect upon our lives over the course of the last 12 months. And as we reflect and make goals in our own personal lives, it's also important that we ask God, what as a church? As a worshiping community, what do we need to be doing to help shine the light of Christ in a world that so desperately needs love and hope and healing? As I prayed to God about God's vision for my life, and I asked that God continually order my steps, I also pray about the life and mission of this church. And I encourage you to do the same, to continue doing the same. Because praying over your church is so crucial. And dare I say, praying for your church is a moral imperative. Because God has placed each and every one of us in this sacred space and community for a purpose and a reason. From the youngest to the most seasoned of members, God needs your hands. God needs your feet and your voices to accomplish God's work in this part of God's vineyard. And I believe with every fiber in my being that God has a mighty purpose and plan for St. Paul's Episcopal Church. And all we have to do is continue to walk in faith that God will equip all of us with the tools required to accomplish that purpose. So when we pray about our church, when we pray over our church, when we pray about St. Paul's, we should first thank God in advance for the work that God is doing in our own lives and the lives of our youth, our young adults, our sisters and brothers here in this community. We need to ask God to watch over our church family, to protect them and bless them, and bless their health, especially as we are still grappling with COVID and its many variants. Pray and ask God to bless their health, their body, their heart, and spirit. We need to pray and ask that God created each and every one of us a new heart and spirit, to stir up a passion and commitment to be active disciples, witnessing to the power and love of Christ Jesus, witnessing in both word and action. Because friends, we serve a God of abundance. We serve a God of abundance, not a God of lack or scarcity. If we read the first half of our Psalm from 147, it reminds us that we serve a God that is mighty in power. Our God makes the grass to grow upon the mountains and makes green plants to serve humanity. God provides food for flocks and herds and the young ravens. What does that mean? That means that God supplies each and every one of our needs. God provides. God does not abandon. God will never abandon his creation. Rest assured that we are never left to fend for ourselves. Even when we're struggling and it seems like the world is against us and all we're doing is just enough to make it through the day, trust and believe that God is right there with you. God is right there with all of us, loving us, making a way when we can't see one, leading and guiding us when we can't even see the next step in front of us. But let us pray that our faith may be bigger than our fears, that our faith would be bigger than what we cannot see, because we serve a God that is bigger than our circumstances. And as you pray in your own personal time of devotion, ask that God would grant you confidence in the gifts that God has blessed you with. Because God has given each and every one of us gifts and talents and skills. And we have a responsibility to use those gifts and talents and skills to the glory of God and the benefit of this beloved community. And if you're not sure what your gift or talent or skill is just yet, then ask God to reveal it to you. Ask God how God wants you to show up using that gift or talent and skill. And in your prayers, pray for me as your rector. Pray for the bishop and clergy of this diocese. Ask God to strengthen us as we do the work of pastoral care, of preaching and teaching and leading. Pray also for our lay leaders as they assist in carrying out the mission and vision of this church. Pray for our young people. Pray that God would give them the strength to hold on to their faith in a world that is unsteady and confusing. Pray for all those who may walk through our doors or click on our live stream, looking for a place to worship, looking for a place to call home. Those who are seeking after God, just seeking a safe space to be, or just in need of a place to pray. Friends, I think we can all agree in the power of prayer. I know I wouldn't be standing before you today if I didn't know that to be true. God has shown up and shown out in my life in these last 12 months, and all I can do is give glory and praise to God. There is power in prayer. There's power in the prayers of a community of faith. And as vital, though, as prayer is to our daily lives, so is taking the time to sit and be still and listen to what God has to say, to listen to what God's response is to our petitions. Because prayer isn't just a one-sided list of requests from us to God, but rather prayer is a dialogue between the Creator and us, God's creation. So it's imperative that we make the space to listen to the voice of God. We have to create spaces where we're free from distractions and all the outside noises, because we know there's plenty of noise just competing for our attention. But we can't hear God if we're too busy and too distracted by life. Make the time to sit and be still and listen. And I pray that in this coming year, in 2022, that we would walk boldly in our faith. Walk boldly, trusting in God's plans for our lives and for this community. For this community of dedicated sisters and brothers in Christ. Because friends, God's word does not return void. It accomplishes all that God has purposed. Our prayers will never return void. And I pray that we trust in God's might and power, believing that with God, all things are possible. There's no limit to God's wisdom. There's no limit to what God can do, so we dare not lower our expectations of God's ability. Because out of God's love for us, God became flesh and dwelt among us. That is what we are celebrating in this Christmas season. God became flesh and dwelt among us, fully human and fully divine. Out of love for us, God gave God's only Son, heaven's perfect Lamb, to wash away our sins. The light of the incarnate Word has been poured upon us. And I pray, my sisters and brothers, that God would enkindle this light in our heart so that it may shine forth in our lives and in the lives of those around us. I pray that the light of Christ shines brighter and stronger so that this church, St. Paul's, continues to be a beacon of light and hope in the heart of this